I have missed it. I didn't replace my numbers. Look at that. I was all ready to start. I didn't replace my numbers. So, gotta do that. Video number four, the I-4. So we have a patient with, there's his eye right there, and his near point is 50 centimeters away, which of course is further than the average for a human being. Typically 25 centimeters, so this person may be about my age, a little bit on the older side of life. Has a near point that's a little bit too far away and wants to be able to see an object at 25 centimeters. So the near point's at 50 centimeters. The object is at 25 centimeters. Now this person cannot focus on that object because it's within the near point. Okay? And so we need to give this person some corrective lenses to fix this. Okay? Because this is a farsighted patient. Yes, a farsighted patient. We need converging lens to correct the farsightedness, which means converging lenses, of course, have positive focal lengths. And that's what we want to know. If we give this person corrective lenses, okay, there's the glasses, you know, the side view with the glasses. The question is, what focal length do we need? We know it's going to be positive, but we want to know what focal length of lens does this person need to see, okay? And here's the idea behind a question like this. We know the object distance equals 25 centimeters, right? That's where the object is. We want to correct it so that the person can see that object, but the person's near point is 50 centimeters away, which means that the image distance has to be 50 centimeters. In other words, we need to trick the eye into thinking that that object is back there at the near point. We need to trick the eye into thinking that the object is at the near point, which means that the image must be at the near point. Okay? Image distance 50 centimeters. Okay? Now we need the image to be upright. It would make no sense to give somebody some glasses. Hey, Paul, here's some glasses to fix your vision problem. And I put them on, but the world is completely clear, but upside down. So we need to have an image that's upright. But remember that upright images are virtual. Now the image created in the back of my eye on my retina will be real. But the image created by my glasses has to be virtual, which means an upright virtual image always has, remember this from last week, or from rather, yeah, from that last week and this week, that means that the image distance has to be negative. Remember, the distances with lenses and mirrors have nothing to do with a number line. They have to do with whether the image is real or virtual. And this image has to be virtual because it has to be upright. And if it's virtual and upright, it's got to have a negative image distance. Okay? Negative 50 centimeters. So now we know the object distance, right? We can't move the object. The bug's right there, 25 centimeters away from the eyes. The image distance has to be the near point. We need to trick the eye into thinking the bug is back there. So it's got to look like the bug is back there, which means the image distance, because what we're seeing is the image created by the glasses, okay? The image has to be back there at 50 centimeters, but it's gotta be negative because it's gotta be upright. Remember, all these things go together and the arrows really work both ways. It's a package deal, a three-way package deal. So now we can solve for F. 1 over F is 1 over d naught plus 1 over di. It's 1 over 25 minus 1 over 50. Right, there's my minus sign. Because of my negative image distance. You solve this and you get that f is 50.0 centimeters. That is the focal length of the corrective lenses we have to use to make sure the eye sees the thing. Okay? To make sure to trick the eye into thinking that the object, which is really 25 centimeters away, looks like it's 50 centimeters away. And if it's 50 centimeters away, it's at the near point and the eye can focus on it. That's how that works. So the power here is going to be 1 over 0.5 meters, right? Because 50 centimeters, last time I checked, equaled 0.5 meters. So the power is plus 2 diopters. Okay. Power for the lenses to correct this situation is 0.5, is plus 2 diopters. Focal length, 50 centimeters. And this is what the little number, the reading glasses that you go to, the, you know, go down to CVS and buy the cheapo reading glasses. You got the ones, the twos, the threes. Those are diopters. Okay. The bigger the diopter, the more powerful the lenses. Okay. So the longer the focal length, the less the power. Okay. So that's what you're reading there. 2.5, 3, whatever. Okay. Okay, so we're at 7 minutes for this video. I'm going to keep on going. I'm going to add one little twist to it, erase the right-hand side, and make one point. That is that my lenses, you'll notice from the side, my lenses are not actually at the location of my eye. There's a little bit of a distance there between my eye and the lenses. Okay, in other words, we didn't make up for the fact that there's this distance right there. Okay, we didn't correct for that. We need to correct this math for that issue. That's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to erase this and redo it with math, assuming that the distance is, say, 2.0 centimeters between my lenses, or rather between this patient's lenses and his corrective lenses and his eye's lenses. Behind my glasses, in front of my eye, about 2 centimeters, that little distance there. Because that's going to make a difference. And that needs to be taken into account when this is really done. Now the object distance will, and image distances will both change. Object and image distances are measured relative to the glasses. Okay. So how do I have this worded here? So the question is now, given that we have a distance of 2 centimeters between the glasses and the eye, how does that affect the calculation? Well, both, so if there's 2.0 centimeters between the corrective lenses in the eye lens, then both DI and DO have to be reduced by 2.0 centimeters. Okay. Because the image has to be a total of 50 centimeters away from the eye, right? DI must be reduced because the image must be 50 centimeters from the eye. Okay. The eye's got to think that the object is 50 centimeters away. And so when it sees the image 50 centimeters away, right, that's its near point. That's got to be fixed. So DI must be reduced because of that, and DO must be reduced because, how did I word it here? Because the object is still 25 centimeters from the eye, right? But the image and object distances are measured relative to the corrective lens. Okay, so now if the lens is 2 centimeters further out that way, that takes 2 centimeters away from the object distance. So DI now, let's do DO first. DO is going to be 23 centimeters, because now our lenses are 2 centimeters further from our eye, but the object hasn't moved, so that distance has been reduced by 2 centimeters. DI is going to be 48.0 centimeters, 50 minus 2, because we still must trick the eye into thinking that the image is 50 centimeters from the eye. 48 centimeters come from between the lens and the image, and 2 centimeters of that come from the distance between the lens and the eye. So with these two values, we'd play the same game. 1 over f is, should actually be negative 48 centimeters. 1 over 23 minus 1 over 48. So both distances have been reduced by that 2 centimeters. If you do that math, you get, where is it now? F is 44.2 centimeters. And the power now is 2.26. diopters, okay? So we figured out the focal length and the power, okay, for both not correcting for that distance and then correcting for that distance. All right? All right, that's it. That's it for this example. I will see y'all later.